In this video I demonstrate how to close a face I have here from the Curves workbench a profile, and I want to close it. So I have for this case the close face node. This is the reference to this face, and the face is the input for the close face node. And now when I select the close face node, I can visualize it, and I see here the new surface. This is a closed and periodic surface, and it has here the same multiplicities in this area. That means that it's the same face as the origin face. And there are some parameters. The first thing is I can change here the tangent force when I make it larger. Then in this case I go from here on a wide way to the opposite side, and I can say tangent force is nearly zero, so I go the straight way. And the other parameter is swap. When I click swap, then I get in this case these two edges connected. So I always have the decision what kind of model I want to build. Okay, let's see another use case. In this case I hide the other one. In this case I have here this object, this tube. Okay, and I have here a reference of this tube. In the next moment I create a segment. So I connect this shape, I hide the tube, and I start to visualize the segment. So I see it, and now I can cut a bit of this segment, for example this, and now I have this segment. And in the next step I create here a close face, and I connect the shape of the segment with the input of the closed shape. And here is the closed shape. I visualize it and I execute it, and we see here I get a new closed face. I can hide this, and we see here once more it is a closed face, and we can look back to the original tube, and we see we have started here in a tangent way. We go to the opposite side, and we can here change the force. We make it larger or smaller. Okay, and we also can change we can change of the closed face the direction. I click here swap, and in this case I get these two edges connected. This is an object, this doesn't make sense, but the other direction I think can be useful.